हेलो नमस्कार। इन दिस सेक्शन वील बी सीइंग पॉइसन्स इन लैपलास इक्वेशंस। सो प्रीवियसली इफ यू रिमेंबर द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी वॉज कैलकुलेटेड आइदर विद द हेल्प ऑफ कूलम्स लॉ, गॉस लॉ, और व्हेन आई नो अ चार्ज डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन अक्रॉस अ गिवन स्पेस आई वॉज यूजिंग द इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल एट दैट पर्टिकुलर स्पेस एंड आई वॉज कैलकुलेटिंग इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी। If you remember the scalar potentials are E is equal to minus del V or the gradient of scalar potential. That is how we actually calculated electric field intensity. But whenever I go for practical situations, I'll be neither knowing the distribution of charge in a given space or I don't know what is the potential distribution across a given region. So there where I'll be using Poisson's and Laplace equations application. So what Poisson's and Laplace equations will be using is it will be basically considering the boundary conditions wherein it will be knowing the variations of electrostatic charges across the boundary, and with the help of that I'll be calculating the charge and potential. So basically this thing holds good with respect to static conditions. Okay, so let's see what is that Poisson's and Laplace equations and how is that being derived. So if you remember, we had defined the Gauss law as the divergence of my electric field density or electric flux density, which was given by the charges enclosed in that particular closed volume, right? So this is the equation which we had derived or which we got from the Gauss law. So this is Gauss law, if you remember. But we also know that my electric flux density is related to electric field intensity with respect to variable epsilon, where epsilon is the permittivity of the given medium. Okay, so substituting this in this expression yields del dot D can be written as del dot epsilon naught E is equal to rho V. So this is what I get after substituting that. And in the electric potential unit, we also had a relation between electric field intensity and the scalar potential. So if you remember that, that relation was nothing but my electric field intensity E was given as the negative gradient of the scalar potential V. So this is what we had derived in unit 2. So substituting this in this particular expression, I'll call this as A now. Substituting that in A, I'll be ending up at del dot epsilon naught minus del V is equal to rho V. So this is what I have ended up at, wherein if I multiply negative or I can take the negative that side, the equation becomes simply del dot del times epsilon naught V is equal to rho V. If I have, okay, the negative sign. If I have a homogeneous medium, for an homogeneous medium, this equation can be written as, I'll call this as B, for a homogeneous medium. Homogeneous means to say I have a similar medium, the medium is constant. Homogeneous medium, my equation B can be written as del dot del V is equal to minus rho V over epsilon naught, or in other sense this can also be written as del square V is equal to minus rho v over epsilon naught. So this equation, whatever you are seeing now, this equation is called as Poisson's equation. So what this Poisson's equation had is, if I know the charge distribution across the medium, then I could have found out the square of the scalar potential, or square of the potential, or the divergence square of the potential across a given field. So if there is no charge available within that particular medium, so if there is no charge at all, if I take a space and it is a charge free space, if this is a charge free space, then what happens to my rho v? Rho v becomes zero because there is no charge at all in that space. At that moment, the Poisson's equation can be written as del square dot v is equal to zero. So this is what is called as Laplace equation. So this is actually a special case of equations where there is a charge free region. If I consider a charge free region, then I can get that my del square v, or the potential at that particular point, will be zero. So taking this into consideration, this equation holds good for a homogeneous medium. That is what I have told till now. If it is a non-homogeneous medium, then what happens here is, this equation B holds good, and this equation B is simply going to be as it is. There is no change in this equation B, and I cannot now take this homogeneity, or the permittivity constant, towards my RHS, and this equation have to be solved as it is. And this is what called as the Poisson's equation for a non-homogeneous medium. Okay. Keep that in mind. This is the Poisson's equation for a non-homogeneous medium. Similarly, if I have a free space or free charge where I don't have any charge, then the right hand side becomes zero, then that will be a Laplace equation. So del dot epsilon naught times del v, or the other way around, both are same because epsilon naught is a constant. So del dot epsilon naught v is equal to zero. This will be called as Laplace equation for non-homogeneous medium. So this is about Poisson's and Laplace equations, where we'll be using applications of this equation in finding out whether there is a charge in a given space or not. How can we do that? If I solve for this equation and if the right hand side becomes zero, then that means to say that given space is a free of charge, like the given space is not at all having any charges at all. The given space has a free charge free region. Okay, so what is this formula del square v looks like? To show you that, basically what we can do is, this probably you all know. So del square v can be written as del square v dot, or partial derivative of v square of that, plus del square v with respect to del y square, plus del square v over del z square, can be written as zero for a Cartesian system. So I am representing Laplace equation in terms of all the three systems. Okay, for Cartesian system, this is the expression. For a cylindrical coordinate system, the equation becomes 1 by rho into partial derivative with respect to rho of rho times डेल वी ओवर डेल रो प्लस वन ओवर रो स्क्वायर डेल स्क्वायर वी ओवर डेल फाई स्क्वायर प्लस डेल स्क्वायर वी ओवर डेल जी स्क्वायर. सो दिस इज फॉर सिलेंड्रिकल कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम. सिमिलरली फॉर अ स्पेरिकल कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम वी हैव ओके आई विल बी चेंजिंग द इंक. सो इट इज वन ओवर आर स्क्वायर टाइम्स द पार्शियल डेरिवेटिव ओवर आर आर स्क्वायर डेल रो और टू आर प्लस वन बाई आर स्क्वायर साइन टीटा पार्शियल डेरिवेटिव ओवर टीटा ऑफ साइन टीटा डो वी डो टीटा प्लस वन ओवर आर स्क्वायर साइन स्क्वायर टीटा इंटू डो स्क्वायर वी बाई डो फाई स्क्वायर. सो दिस इज फॉर अ स्पेरिकल कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम. सो दिस आर द थ्री मेन इक्वेशंस दैट वी नीड टू सॉल्व फॉर टू फाइंड आउट वेदर देर इज अ चार्ज. इफ देर इज अ चार्ज देन इट इज नॉट अ स्पेस वेयर लैपलास होल्ड्स गुड. ओके सो वी कैन प्रूव दैट वेदर दैट पर्टिकुलर गिवन स्पेस इज अ लैपलासियन स्पेस और मीन्स टू से वेदर देर इज अ फ्री ऑफ चार्जेस एंड और नॉट. सो दैट्स अबाउट लैपलास एंड पॉइसन्स इक्वेशंस. वील बी सीइंग द नेक्स्ट पार्ट इज यूनिकनेस थियरम वेयर वील बी डीलिंग अ स्पेशल काइंड ऑफ बाउंड्री कंडीशन प्रॉब्लम दर. थैंक यू.